Sir Cliff Richard recently pointed out that he made the first rock and roll record at Abbey Road Studios before the Beatles. The legendary band, who comprised John Lennon, Paul McCartney, George Harrison and Ringo Starr, rose to fame in the 1960s. The Beatles have become synonymous with Abbey Road, which is located in northwest London that houses one of the world's most famous recording studios, as well as the famous Zebra Crossing. The band recorded almost all of their singles and albums at the London studio in St. John's Wood, usually setting up shop in Studio 2. The Fab Four even named their last album Abbey Road, which featured the iconic image of the band using the zebra crossing not far from the studio's door. Sir Cliff, who scored his first number one hit in 1959, has opened up about the Battle of Abbey Road. The veteran performer opened up about recording Move It with his band, then called the Drifters, at Abbey Road. The building had been converted into a studio at the start of the 1930s, as Cliff revealed he rented out Abbey Road to the band when they were up and coming. Now everybody thinks the Beatles kind of owned it. They owned Studio 2, the singer stated. In actual fact, I owned it, and I rented it to them, just a little bit, on and off. He added to Gold Radio UK, of course, we'll never be able to take it from them that they made Abbey Road famous. Sir Cliff continued, we were early. We were doing singles for 2 or 3 years. They came in, singles and then albums. And of course, the Abbey Road album came out, and of course, that's what made the studio famous. But I still like to think that really I helped make it famous. Though I didn't make an album called Abbey Road. Victoria Beckham says husband's heartbroken over Harper latest Sir Mick Jagger, 79, pops out for pint at London pub with brother pictures Danny Baker hits out as he claims Prince George forced to wear suit royals. Elsewhere, Sir Cliff opened up about the longevity of his career, which has spanned over 7 decades. Richard Arnold spoke with Sir Cliff Richard during Friday's Good Morning Britain to discuss the singer's latest Christmas album and his annual calendar, which he has been releasing every year for 20 years. Reflecting on his career success, the songwriter explained, I started when I was 17, recording in the corner of the studio in Abbey Road in 1958, before the Beatles, by the way. I don't think that the decades are gonna fly by the way they do. So for me, I really hadn't touched the ground, and I keep thinking, will anybody else do that? However, the singer admitted that it must come to an end at some point. You're not just talking about Christmas, the GMB host said. The calendar, of course, is the gift that keeps on giving. We've done it for like 20-odd years now, the singer explained. So this year, I think the calendar has been photographed by people who came to the last gig. Last year's calendar, we did get to number one, so we keep our fingers crossed, but it must come to an end,